Okay, to perform model analysis, so what are the material properties are mandatory? So one is density. So the vibration or natural frequencies depends on the material stiffness and the density. Okay, material stiffness. So here you just say model analysis is performed to find the fundamental frequencies and their associated behavior, that is mode shape. So once you find out the natural frequency, for each natural frequencies we are going to find out the mode shape. Okay,
yes.
So every material, every component or every system or every machine structure is having its own operating frequency. Okay, suppose consider if any vehicle, any automotive vehicle is having around 100 hertz of operating frequency. Once you perform the model analysis, if the natural frequency is coming nearer or coinciding with the natural operating frequency, then a resonance will occur. Okay, so that's why it is very important to find out the natural frequency. If those natural frequencies are coinciding with the operating frequency, then we can say that the vibration will occur and the material may fail at any time. Okay.
Yes, sir.
If the natural frequencies are beyond the operating frequency, then the material cannot vibrate. This is the theoretical part. Okay. So here model analysis is a fundamental analysis that is always performed alongside the static structural analysis to understand the behavior of the product under consideration. So this we have to perform along with the static structural analysis. I will tell you how to perform along with the static structural analysis. Okay, so here we have an example. Okay, so this is the entire system. Okay, here this is a structure. On this structure the motor and compressor has been mounted. Okay, so if the motor rotates at 3600 rpm, if the motor is rotating at 3600 rpm, what is the frequency? Frequency would be 3600 divided by 60, that is 60 hertz, right? So suppose if you are finding out the if you are performing model analysis of any two wheeler or any four wheeler, you have to find out what is the RPM of the particular maximum RPM, okay?
Yes, sir.
Of the particular car, okay, or particular two wheeler. So here the combined frequency of the motor and the framework found to be 60 hertz. The entire system is having a natural operating frequency of 60 hertz. The structure would vibrate with high amplitude and would eventually fail. If the structure will vibrate, then the structure may fail at any time. Okay, as I told you, the structure cannot be declared safe only on the load withstanding capability. So as I told you, you have to perform static structural analysis. With that static structural analysis, we cannot say that the structure can withstand the loads. Okay, and it is also important to find out the model analysis. Okay, but should be safe considering the structural dynamic aspect as well. Okay, so this is one of the example of model analysis. This is the Tacoma Narrow Bridge. So it is located in US. So was a narrow bridge, was a suspension bridge in the US. See, this is called a suspension bridge. So what happens, the failure of the bridge occurred when a never before seen twisting mode. So here, due to the high wind speed, there was some twisting occurred in the bridge. Due to that twisting, the bridge has been collapsed. Okay, this is one of the best example of modal analysis. So if you won't conduct any vibration, that is modal analysis, so that we cannot say that the stability of the structure. Okay,
sir.
So this is the frequency. So the frequency depends on time, with respect to time. So this is So all of you, I will just say, I think I already shared you the PPT in the beginning itself. So here, yes, how to control the vibration, how to control the vibration, okay, by using dampers. So this is the viscous damping, this is the spring, okay, spring damping, viscous damping. But providing the damping, we can avoid the vibration in a system, okay?
Yes sir.
So here the modal analysis, as I told you, depends on three factors. One is mass, that is the weight of the component, stiffness of the component, and damping provided to the component, okay? So mass, the quantity matter present inside the object. Stiffness, what is the stiffness? Force required to produce an unit deflection in an object, that is called stiffness, okay? Whatever the force we are going to apply, that should produce the unit deflection, that is called stiffness. Damping, it is a property or a characteristic of an object to lose energy, okay? So what type of damping we have? Structural damping, we have viscous damping, dry friction. See, structural damping is nothing but energy dissipated due to intramolecular friction, okay? There will be a molecules inside the component, right? Inside a member, inside a material. So the energy, whatever the energy dissipates from that intermolecular friction, that is called structural damping. So viscous damping, so energy dissipated in the fluid due to their viscous in nature. Okay. So this is the viscous damping. So this is the, this depends, entirely depends on the fluid. So dry friction or Coulomb damping is energy loss due to surface to surface contact. Okay. If you are having a system with surface to surface contact, it provides dry friction damping. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So here, mode. What is mode? The frequency at which the body vibrates. Okay. See, the frequency at which body vibrates, that is called mode. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So for natural bodies, there are infinite number of natural frequencies are present. So here, in any body, we have infinite number of natural frequencies. Okay. So here, while performing modal analysis of any component of any body, you have to perform at least 5 to 10 natural frequencies. Based on that, we can say that the stability of a structure, of a stability of a component. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So mode shape is nothing but to represent the shape or a pattern which the body is going to take at certain natural frequency. Suppose if you are having a natural frequency of 100 Hz, for that particular 100 Hz, what will be the shape of deflection of the component? So I will show you at the time of analysis. Lowest natural frequency is known as fundamental frequency of an object. Okay. So here, one thing I would like to tell you. So while performing modal analysis, you should require Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio, and density. These three properties should require. Without density, you cannot perform modal analysis. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So here, structural and thermal notes are not available in the free vibration. If you are performing free vibration, we should not require any thermal loads. If no loads are present, rigid body modes will occur at or near zero. So here, when performing modal analysis, we should not apply any loads. Okay, only we need to give supports, that is fixed. Okay, I will show you how to perform all those things. So this is one of the example for modal analysis. So here titanium alloy is used. Type of constant, fixed support and free at the end. Here one end we have fixed, another end we have left it as free. First, find the first 6 natural frequencies in mode. I will show you how to perform. So this is also an example for modal analysis. This is the Audi car bumper. So here we have found out the 5 natural frequencies. Okay. So this is also one of the examples. See, this is the pre-stressed modal analysis. So if a component is having pre-stressed means, say in the guitar, the strings has been stressed at a certain force, right?
Yes, sir.
So at the particular pre-stressed force, what will be the vibration if you apply load on it? So once we put finger on the string, the music will come, right? Okay. Yes. So what will be the strength of the string, we can find out. And this is the hanging bridge. For this, see, this is also has been pre-stressed, and this is the jet engine. So this is already I have shown you. Okay, fine. So we'll see. So we'll move to workbench. So here, so if you want to see last session, we have done with structural analysis, right?
Yes.
So you have already saved it. So how to open it? So here I have saved it. So here, see the connecting rod, right?
Yes.
So if you want to open the saved ANSYS file, you just double click on the connecting rod. Whatever the workbench file you have saved, you just double click it, directly you will get it.
Yes, sir.
So it will take time to open because already we have saved the project. I think we have not saved properly. So last class, which project we have done? Which component?
The crankshaft.
Oh, camshaft. Okay, let it be. We will do it once again. Okay, so you just open the project page. So go to static structural analysis, drag it on your project schematic. So engineering data, already I told you, if you want to modify the engineering data, you can modify. So unit, you can change it in terms of millimeter or anything. So geometry, what I will do, I will just right click on the geometry, go to import geometry, browse. I will import connecting rod here. So I'll just go to desktop. Here we have online connecting rod and give open. Okay, next double click on the model. So you so in ANSYS we can do n number of types of analysis, and also in ANSYS workbench we can perform create 3D model also. Okay, so if you want to learn entire ANSYS workbench, it will take around two and a half months. So we'll wait until it opens. See here, starting mechanical. So still it takes time. So you can check it here, the progress of the project. Okay, now we have got, see, so this is the aircraft connecting rod. So one end is connected with the piston, another end is, see, all of you are getting?
Yes, sir.
One end is connected with the piston, another end is connected with crankshaft. Okay, so when the piston is moving from bottom dead center to top dead center, there will be a tensile force on this and it will be fixed. When the piston is moving bottom dead, moving towards bottom dead center, okay, so this will be fixed, and here we are going to apply compressive load. In both the condition you have to find out. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. So here, first we will perform static structural analysis. So we will mesh it. So go to sizing. We'll go to mesh here. So coarse is there. You just make it fine mesh. Right click and generate mesh. So this is the aircraft connecting rod. So bigger mesh we have got, so we should not get like this. What you can do, so here in the element size you can change it to wait, we'll check what element size we have. So here you can check in statistic how many elements, 1516 elements, nodes we have 3000 something. So if you go to advance, you will get, okay. Mount element. What we'll do? So here, so in the default we have element size. You just make it 5. So you just try it. Once you make it 5, right click, generate image. Oh, it is too big. So what you will do? You make it 1. Okay. Right click, generate image. So now we have got somewhat better compared to previous. All of you got it? All of you got it? Okay, fine. Fine. So here, so what is the next step? What is the next step?
Applying
loads. Applying load. Yeah. So go to static structural, right click, and we'll apply fix it. So initially, what I will do, so you just switch off it. So select this and this. So press Ctrl and select both. So only this and apply. Next, go to static. So we'll apply pressure. Where we should apply pressure? Here. That is a tensile load. So how much low pressure we have to apply? Consider around 3 MPa. Click on this, apply. See? So the so entire surface, the normal pressure is going to apply. It doesn't mean that the load is applying only in this direction. Okay, that is the normal load. You just observe here, you have normal load. Okay, if you want to apply only in this direction, straight away to Z direction, you have to change it here. Click on this normal to click on this drop down menu, go to component, you have to give in the Z direction. That is 3 MPa. See here. Okay, as of now, I want only normal load. So here, go to component, click on this, click on the normal. So this should be 3. Okay, so now we have applied. So next step is right click, insert. We want total deformation. If you want stress, click right click. Yes. Yes, tell me. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Right click on the solution and solve. Okay, see, solution has been, and if you go to total deformation, you can check it. See here. So if you go to this graph, you can check the, see here, how the deformation is going to occur. If you go to equivalent stress, see. So where the stresses are developing more, where we have red color, right? So these are the negligible stress. See? Okay. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, we will see how to perform modal analysis. Okay, so you just minimize this, come to project schematic. You have modal analysis here. See here, modal. Okay, so what you need to do, so we need to see same material we are using, same geometry we are using. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to drag this on this solution. Okay, if you want to merge both the analysis, so drag it here. So once you drag, see everything has been linked. So same material, same component, same model. Once you go to this project schematic, you have got the model here. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here in this model, see no need to mesh anything. So right click on the model. Only thing is you need to solve. So before solving, because we have applied, we have fixed it, right? So only thing is what you have to do, you need to go to analysis setting. Here, how many modes we need to find out? Suppose if you want to find out the 10 modes, just give 10 modes. Okay. Right click on the solution and solve it. So we'll get 10 modes.
Yes.
So here, as I told you, see one thing you have to observe carefully. So this is not free analysis, free vibration analysis. Okay. This is forced analysis because we have applied a pressure. As I told you, while performing natural frequencies, this should not be applied. So what I will do, so keep it as it is. We'll see if you have applied a pressure, that means that is a pre-stressed analysis. Okay. So this is forced vibration analysis. So we have solved it here. So where you have the results. So if you go to tabular data. So here once you go to solution, you have tabular data. See here, all of you are getting.
Yes, sir.
How many frequencies are developing? So these are all the frequencies we are developing. What we'll do, we'll delete this pressure because we are going to find out the free analysis, free vibration analysis. So right click on the solution and solve it. So here, so one mistake I have done. So if you have static, you should have to apply. So we'll do one thing. Go to project schematic. Here, you just delete this link. See? And delete this also. Only thing is we have to link material and geometry. I will close this also. See, observe carefully here. So whatever the procedure I have done, that is for forced or pre-stressed analysis. So select this, delete this. Why it is not deleting? So you do one thing, we'll do it in the beginning. So just delete this. So it has to delete. See here, you can check the status here. Yeah. So what you can do, click on this model, drag it here. So I want same material what we have used for static. What you can do, drag this engineering data to this engineering data of model analysis. The same material we can use. Drag this geometry to the geometry of the model analysis. Okay. Next, double click on this model. So you will get the model analysis workbench. See here. So we'll go to meshing, make it a one, and we'll make it fine mesh. Right click, generate mesh. See, all of you are getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we have done the meshing. Next, only thing is we need to apply boundary condition. Insert, fixed. See here, we are getting only the supports. We are not getting any loads. See here, we are not getting any pressure or anything. Go to fixed, yes, sir. Support. So switch off this. Press Control and select this and apply. See, next go to analysis settings here. If you want five mode shapes, you just press it five and right click solve. See here, we have done with this. So we'll check how many. So if you click on the solution, once you go to tabular data, you have, so these many frequencies, natural frequencies we have got. See, this is the component of aircraft. Okay. So this is the component of aircraft. Obviously, you should have more operating frequency. You just find out. So suppose this is having 1000 hertz of operating frequency. What you see, you need to, once you, if you want to check the mode shapes, so select all the frequencies, right click and create a mode shape result. See here, you have all the mode shapes. Okay, again right click on the solution, evaluate result. So you will get all the mode shapes. See, go to total deformation. Yeah, got. See, this is the mode shape one. You just observe here. See, frequency of 2033.2 hertz. See here, how the shape is coming. So you can check it here. See, this is the translation mode shape. See here. So if you go to deformation two, you can check here. So this is the translation along this axis. So this is the natural frequency we are getting. How much? 4000 something. If you go to this, see, this is the bending moment. So if you go to this, see, you can observe. So this is one type of natural frequency. See here, if you go to deformation 4, this is the twisting moment. See, so this is the twisting moment. So if this twisting moment, see whatever the 12,000 something hertz we are getting, if we get around 1,000 hertz, that means the material may vibrate at any time. Okay, so if you go to this, you will check. This is the translation mode. See here. All of you are getting. Any doubts?
Yes, sir.
So this is how you can perform modal analysis. Okay. So for each component, you have to perform modal analysis. That is very important to perform modal analysis to find out the vibration of a component, or to find out the structural stability. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you can do it for your with respect to your project. Okay, so tomorrow, maybe I will try to complete this internship, because we have left with thermal analysis as well as buckling analysis. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
When do we submit the project?
So I will tell you after completion of this internship program.
Okay, sir. Yes.
So can you just switch on your videos? Just for attendance sake. Please switch on your videos. Salim. Salim, Shankar, Manoj. Shankar.
Sir,
yeah. Okay, shall I end off the session?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.